Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. About a week or a week and a half ago, as part of the old cookbook show, we did a recipe for a 1930s waffle. And I mentioned that it wasn't the waffle recipe that Julie and I used most often, and a lot of people asked to see that recipe. So I'm going to make it today. In this jug, I have some flour, just regular all-purpose flour. To that, I'm going to add some baking powder, salt, and just a little bit of sugar. The sugar is not going to make them sweet. It's just going to help the color a little bit as it bakes. So a little bit of a whisk, bring that all together. Now over here I have a measuring jug, and to that I'm going to add some milk. And some plain yogurt. And I just want to bring that measurement up to about that much. Now, if you don't have yogurt, you could use sour cream, you could use kefir, you could use buttermilk, cultured buttermilk. And if you don't have any of those things, just use all milk. Don't say to me, oh, I could put lemon juice in or vinegar in. This recipe doesn't need acid. Doesn't need acid at all because we used baking powder. The reason I used yogurt is I wanted the flavor from the yogurt. Really, it was all about flavor. All about flavor. And so all of those things that I just listed are going to bring that flavor, but lemon juice or vinegar is not going to bring the flavor. So you could just go ahead and use straight milk at that point if that's what you have. So I'll give this a whisk. And while I'm whisking, we'll check the waffle iron and see if it's hot yet, but it's still heating. And because it's still heating, I can't move on to the next step because I don't want to mix the wet into the dry and start that reaction with the baking powder until this is hot. So we'll wait. Okay, we're hot. So in go the liquid ingredients and some melted butter. And I just whisk this together until it's nice and smooth.
Woohoo! It smells like Sunday morning.
It does smell like Sunday morning, doesn't it? Okay, so a little bit of maple syrup. Now, this is the third waffle iron we've gone through.
Yeah, we like waffles.
So this one is, we haven't used it very much, so I'm just kind of getting a handle on how much to pour in each square. Because every waffle iron is different. We've never had two that have been the same.
Quite the same, no.
No.
And then as much as we use our waffle iron, it's hard to commit to buying a waffle iron because you think there's only one use. But if you look way back in our catalog, we had a little adventure with trying different things in...
cookies, hash browns, all kinds of different things that we cooked in it.
But of course, waffles are just tasty, crispy treats.
So I really like these because I like the vanilla. It's got... that brings a different flavor to it. It has less egg than the recipe we did 2 weeks ago. Mm-hmm. So you don't get that Yorkshire pudding flavor, which is a very eggy flavor to me.
So for some people, yes. But I think the yogurt or sour cream that you add to it
keeps
it nice and moist. And
it changes the texture and adds an incredible amount of flavor as
and
well.
And I will admit that I actually, not only do I usually not have syrup, I might have jam. I often just eat them straight up.
Yeah.
I don't know.
And to me, it always smells like going to the fair, CNE, with my grandfather and getting two waffles with a slice of ice cream through the middle. They used to have paper cartons, rectangular paper cartons of ice cream, and they would just slice off the ice cream, put it between two waffles. And as a kid, that was, yeah, no CNE this year.
That's okay. This is going to be an unusual year for all of us. But we do have other things because you've got something going on over here.
That's the oil heating for the last KFC video. After a year of working on KFC, we are going to be done whether we get it or not.
Okay. Does that mean we get to have chicken and waffles?
We probably will be eating chicken and waffles this week. Maybe some KFC gravy on chicken and waffles. Okay, so thanks for stopping by, everybody. Stay safe, stay healthy. See you again soon.